Let your heart be light. Next year all our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. Next year all our troubles will be miles away. Once again, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who were dear to us will be near to us.
Opening the eyes of the blind, there's no one like. Christmas pageant. It's called No Stress, No Fuss Christmas Pageant. Christmas is pray, Heavenly Father, that you fill this place with your glory. Help all the kids, Lord God, to be calm, to be really just in their character, and to really be able to minister to each one of us tonight. I pray that you fill this place with your glory. We thank you for your love and mercy, and we pray all these things in Christ's glorious name. Amen. You may be seated.
And welcome everyone to Bethlehem. Let us open our eyes and our ears and listen to the story of when Christ was born. Part 1, Mary and Joseph. Mary and Joseph, a pitiful sight. So tired and dirty, they gave me a fright. Sickly or dying, what was the matter? A room in the inn, impossible chatter. My rooms are all taken, not one empty bed. There'll not be a room in all of Bethlehem, I said. but their eyes told a story of hunger and need. I couldn't avoid them, so I tried a good deed. I cleaned up the stable. Rachel cooked up a meal. We helped all we could. At least that's how I feel. For we noticed that Mary was expecting, and soon, so we prepared a delivery right under the moon. The child came so quickly, his face seemed a light, as if God had shown God's presence so bright. Joseph said softly, "It's Jesus, my friend. God sent him among us to bring to an end fear and hatred, darkness and sin. Instead, God gave light to let God's love in. My animals are calm, quieter than normal. They often were noisy and never too formal. They always were eating and else they were sleeping. The stable required continuous sweeping. But on Christmas night, they were strangely in awe at the sight of the babe and all that they saw. It's as if they were aware that God had just hushed them, had fed and watered and carefully brushed them. They knew, I believe, that God had been able to work a miracle there in that stable." We don't often see angels in flight, but on the first Christmas, they lit up the night, appeared to the shepherds, and boy, were they scared. Angels, cried one, will any lives be spared? Are they here to destroy us in our time of earth up? Have we seen our last day? Have we drank our cup? But peace on earth, goodwill to men, was the angel's sweet song that was their call.
with light show that dazzled all who did see. The angels hallelujahed and sang out with glee. To Bethlehem shepherds the angels directed to see Jesus the Christ, whom God has perfected. Go worship the Lord and follow his ways, and you'll find Christmas joy for all of your days. The shepherds, I told you, were scared and they stunned. Too much hard work or too much hot sun. That's what they thought. That's how they explained. Perplexed and afraid, they loudly complained. But the angel song calmed them and they believed. They rejoiced when they knew that they were quite relieved. They went to the stable and worshiped the Lord. Then they left and began to spread the good word. Thank you. led wide persons at night to Bethlehem's stable, to the manger's strange light. They came bearing gifts in worship and love, praising God for God's wonders from heaven above. The wise men were kings, and they knelt on the straw. It was the oddest of things that I ever had saw. If kings bring me treasure, then maybe you too can worship and pleasure the person of Jesus who came to us all. So worthy of praise, for he brings us God's call. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Come to God for healing from strife. Come unto me, all you who labor, and I will give you rest forever to savor. Was the very first Christmas, and there in the manger, the Christ child was born. It couldn't have been stranger. Shepherds saw angels, wise men a star. They came to see Jesus, they came from afar. They knew as he was special, God's very own son. He came to the earth to love everyone. He grew up in time, the Savior, the Lord, to be worshipped each day, to loved and adored. So now at Christmas, we all take delight in the gift that God gave us the first Christmas night. In the gifts we receive and the ones that we give, let us never forget, it is Christ that we live.
so very much for the children's program for us tonight. We want to thank Sister Tammy Hernandez and Sister Yolanda Krantz and their team for the outstanding job. Children, we're very proud of you. God bless you and thank you. As the children are dismissed, there's another young lady that's going to be sharing an awesome song with us, and we hope that you're blessed with her performance. We're so grateful for young Estrella, or Star, and she has been a real blessing to us, and we pray she's a blessing to you.
Been ostracized for 12 years, abused to being alone. Spent everything I had and now it's gone. Abused to being put down, my issues tell it all. My only hope is anchored in this fall. If I could just touch the hem of his garment, I know I'd be made whole. If I could just press my way through this madness, his love would heal my soul. If only one touch. So many people call him, how could he ever know that just the brush of him would stop the flow? If he knew, would he rebuke me or shame me to the crowd? Well, I'm desperate cause it's never or it's now. If I could just touch the hem of his garment, I know I'd be made whole. If I could just press my way through this madness, his love would heal my soul. And then suddenly he turned around. He said, somebody has unleashed my power. Well, frightened and embarrassed, I bow. You see, I told him of my troubles and how I had to hem of his garment, and I know I've been made whole. And how I had pressed my way through this madness, and his love has healed my soul. Now with the one word he touched, the hem of my garment,
Star is such a blessing. This young lady just has a great ministry and ministers at many of our ministries. If you don't know about some of the ministries we have
ministries here at our church, and then we have another location called God's Warehouse where we minister to the homeless and we provide food and clothing and shelter, and we allow just a lot of outreach to go forth there, and Star ministers there often, and we are so pleased with that. I just want to share with you some thoughts about gifts for Christmas. It's always difficult because when we have Christmas, we put a lot of thought into gift giving, and we put a lot of thought in the things that take place. In the Gospel of Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 through 12, it says, "Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men came from the east to worship. And they came to Jerusalem, saying, 'Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him.' When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all of Jerusalem with him. And when they had gathered all of the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, 'In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, for you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are not the least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you shall come a ruler who will rule his people in Israel.' When Herod heard this, he was greatly disturbed, and he called for the wise men, and he determined from them the time that the star had appeared. And they sent him to Bethlehem, and they said, 'Go and search carefully for the young child, and when you find him, bring back word to me, so that I too may come and worship him.' When they heard the king, they departed, and behold, the star that they had seen in the east went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was. And when they saw the star, they experienced exceedingly great joy. And when they had come to the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. Then, being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way." God, I pray in this short time that you speak to our hearts and let us hear your word to apply to our life. And I pray this in Christ's name, amen. Amen. You know, when we give gifts, we put a lot of thought into it. But gift giving has gone to a whole different level nowadays. I mean, just if I say two words, you're going to know what I mean when I say Black Friday. It's like, oh my gosh. Some of you guys got up at 0.5 hours, you know what I mean? You camped out there and you were there and you enjoyed the craziness and you came back telling your stories and you thought of gifts, and we put different thought into a lot of different gifts that we give. We don't put the same thought into a gift that we give our mother that we do to just someone at the office. But God gave thought to his gift. It says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son." He gave of himself. He gave of his love. And it's really interesting because the wise men came from afar to give a lesson. And there's something great that we can learn from the wise men. Because you know what? They came for a lot of different reasons. But one of the greatest reasons they came was because they had studied. These wise men, or magi as they called them, came from the east. We don't know exactly, but they think, scholars really believe they came from Persia. Persia is what today is Iraq and Iran. And they came and they brought gifts, and they were philosophers and astrologers, and they had studied the stars. And you've got to understand, this is the same place where Daniel was the assistant of King Nebuchadnezzar, and he had been put charge over the whole countryside. So you've got to understand that they had heard much prophecy, because Daniel was a believer and Daniel was a Jew, and he would teach them and he was sharing with them. So you understand that they heard a lot of prophecies. They also saw this phenomenon. Here's a star that had never appeared before is now appearing, and they're going, oh my gosh, we've heard about this. We've heard about the star. We've heard about the prophecies. This has to be the king of the Jews. This has to be the Messiah. He has been born. And they came bearing gifts, and they said, oh my goodness gracious, this is amazing. And they showed amazing perseverance to go there. You've got to understand, they came from a long distance. It's hard traveling even now. I mean, some of us have been traveling, and some people, I don't know if you saw yesterday in Santa Rosa, they had a 40-car pileup. 40 cars. And it was just crazy because of the snow and the ice and the roads, and it was horrible. And they're traveling. They don't have vehicles. The only vehicles they have is camels, donkeys, and horses. And we always say three kings because they brought three separate kind of gifts, but But most scholars really believe that they were traveling with this huge entourage of people, and they were traveling, and they had been traveling for a long time. And if you study, they hadn't really shown up at the manger the way we show it. In all reality, they showed up a lot later on. Jesus might have been close to almost a year and a half, 2 years old. And they really didn't show up even at the stable. They really showed up at their house. And that's why it says the star led them to the house. And when they got there, and that word child in the Greek really means an older child, not a newborn baby, but like a little toddler. And that's why the king was trying to kill off all the kids that were 2 years old and younger. And they started killing the little boys. And they came a long distance. And they came through difficulties. They came through hard weather. They literally traveling like 700 miles. And I don't know about you, if you're traveling 700 miles walking in camel and donkeys and horses, man, it's got to take a long time. A long, long time. That would be like taking a camel from here to L.A. And that'd be tough. I don't know about you. I wouldn't want to do it. I ride a motorcycle, and that's hard enough. But man, a camel, wow. And all the danger they went through, and the robbers that they were confronted by, and just the things that they went, but they persevered because, you know what, they had seen something that they needed to see. My question to us tonight, have we seen anything in the presence of God that we need to see? Has God shown us anything? Do we understand what took place? The kids just did an amazing job of teaching us. But what they brought is even more astounding, because what they brought was gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And you've got to understand that gold is a gift that they would give to a king. It's showing a sovereign dominion. Sovereign meaning he's overall, he's king of it all. And they brought this gift that is for a king, and they brought it and to share this and to hold it and to give him. And they brought frankincense, which is showing that you gave this to supreme deity. This was something that was totally a symbol of great love. It was very, very expensive. It was made from resin, and it was brought together, and they used to use it as this fragrance, and they would use frankincense because it symbolized a supreme deity. It symbolized that they used this fragrance, and they used this in the tabernacle in the temple, and they used it to just give an aroma as unto the Lord, to say, God, you're holy, you're great, you're wonderful, you're good. And then they brought myrrh, and it's really interesting what myrrh is used for. Myrrh is used for someone that dies. It's used for the embalming that they did in those days. Isn't that a weird gift to bring a kid? You're going to bring them myrrh? But you know what? You've got to understand that they brought him gold because Jesus wasn't going to be working that long. Only 30 years did he work in his father's carpentry shop. And then he went off and he started preaching the word, and he was sharing. And some believe that it was off of this gold that he was able to do his ministry. And the frankincense showing that this is truly the anointed one. This is truly the blessed one. This is truly the savored one. But the myrrh was because he was going to have a sacrificial death. And that symbolized that this Christ, this child, was going to be the Christ child that was going to have this sacrificial death for you and for me. And it's really amazing because when they came, it says that they bowed before him. And it's really interesting because they didn't bow before King Herod. Now, we don't know if they bowed or not, but it sure doesn't say it. It just says they entered and they started saying, where is the king? We came to worship the king of the Jews. It's really interesting. They only bowed before the true king. And I guess my question to us tonight is, have we bowed to the true king? Have we really bowed before the Lord? Have we bowed to say, you know what, God? We give you our wealth. We give you our heart. We give you where our treasures are. Because the Bible says where your treasures are, where your heart is, that's where your treasures are. What is it that you have treasured up in your heart? What is it that you're looking for? What is it that is supreme in your life? And I would hope that it's God. And they brought this frankincense. What is it that you're giving? Do you give worship to the king because you know that he is God? Do you really take time to say, God, thank you for all that you've done. Thank you for all that you are. Thank you that everything that you do is amazing, because I recognize your sacrificial death, that you died for me and you gave your life for me and you gave it all up for me. And Lord, I'm so incredibly blessed for that. And because of that, I just say thank you. So tonight, I just want to challenge you, and I want you to think of the gifts that God has given you and what you could give back to the Lord, to give back of your heart, to give back of your life, and to say, God, I give you my treasure. I give you everything I have treasured up in my heart. Anything that I'm holding to be great, I'm surrendering to you that, Lord God, you be God over all of me. That not just part of me, but all of me. And God, then I give you frankincense, the aroma. The Bible says that our life would be a sweet aroma unto God. What is it that you smell like before God? Do you smell like this amazing worship and praise, or do you smell like you've been in places that you shouldn't been? Haven't you ever hugged somebody and you smell and they just smell like, wow, where have you been? Sometimes they smell like tobacco, mega strong, and you're like, oh, man. Sometimes they smell like other smoking things that, you know, are medicinal and illegal some places, and you're like, wow. And some, you know what I'm saying? What is your aroma unto the Lord? Do you have a sweet savor that God goes, oh, I can't believe it. My children are worshiping me. They're praising me. They're a sweet aroma because we're praying unto God. It says that there's literally incense of prayer, bowls of prayers unto the Lord. What is it that you're giving to the King? I just hope and pray that you really serve God with all of your heart, mind, and soul, that you surrender yourself to Christ, that you would really surrender yourself to God, and you'd say, God, thank you so much for all that you've given me and all that you are. And if you've never given your life to the Lord, I really want to make sure you have an opportunity to give your life to Christ. Because that's the greatest gift that you could possibly give God, is your life. And say, God, I realize you died for me. You gave your life for me. Now I want to give my life for you. That, Lord, from this day on, I'll live for you. And if you've never done that, I invite you to do that tonight. If you've never cried out to God, I invite you to cry out tonight. And if you've never done that and you want to do that, I just invite you to raise your hand and say, that's me. I really need the Lord. I've been running from him. Today I want to surrender to him. I don't know if anyone wants to do that, but if you do, just raise your hand. And we just want to pray with you, and we want to encourage you. And we want to say thank you, Lord, for all that you've done. So, Father, we love you, and we praise you, and we give you praise and glory, Lord God. And we thank you for all that you've done and all that you are and all that you continue to be. Thank you for how you ministered our lives, and thank you for what you do in our lives. And, Lord, I just pray that, Lord God, we feel the presence of your Holy Spirit, and, Lord God, that you would always receive our gifts, our gold, the treasures that we've hid in our heart. Might they be worship and praise and dedication, and that we've been consecrated, set aside for you, and that everything that we do in our life would bring glory to you. That you would see praise and you would see adoration and you would see the hand of God. Father God, lead us and guide us. Instruct us. Forgive us, Lord God, for some of the ways we behave at times, for some of the things that we do and say, and some of the things that we think we have a right to do, when, Lord, in all reality, you taught us to live in love and peace and kindness and adoration unto you. So, Father God, we thank you, we praise you, we worship you, and we ask all these things in the mighty name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen and amen and amen. Would you stand with us for this last song before we're dismissed, and just thank the Lord for all that he's doing and all that he has done.
Beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always. center of it all.
Father, thank you so much for this evening. Thank you for these amazing, beautiful little children that have blessed our hearts. Father, I pray that, Lord, you just fill our Christmas with the presence of your holiness and your goodness and mercy. Father, we welcome you into our lives every single moment, every single day, every single hour, and we pray that, Lord, this Christmas will be filled with the presence of your holiness. And Lord, we thank you and pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ our Lord. And God's people said amen. This concludes our service. Thank you so much for being here. And make sure you give the kids a big hug. God bless you.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, próspero año y felicidad. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, próspero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, próspero año y felicidad.
Next year, all our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. Next year, all our troubles will be miles away. Once again, as in olden days, happy golden days of yore. Faithful friends who were dear